Hi, I'm Stephanie. We're back. We're going to do another recipe. So this one is for a diffuser, though. This is one of my favorite go-to recipes. And diffusers, they're contraindicated in our SOP to be utilized in patient care areas because, of course, these are medicinal-grade essential oils, essentially. And so anybody could have an allergic reaction at any time, and we're not going to know who's allergic to what. Anyways, we just don't use diffusers here at CAVHS. So this is for at the house. And 60 milliliters of water, like we talked about. So when you have your diffuser, normally it's got a little, you know, it's got the ticks on it, and it'll have 60 mils. So I just always just kind of fill it up to there because you kind of get tired of the same scent anyways. Oh, and diffusers also, you want to run it on intermediate cycle because you don't want to run it continuous because the body was not going to absorb it as well, versus if you turn it off and on, the body will start kicking off and on and utilize it. So the one that I like the best, this is my go-to for allergy season, is the eucalyptus and peppermint frankincense. So for, again, the eucalyptus, wonderful, wonderful. If you like the smell of it, some people just don't. Frankincense, you know, it's been around forever. It's one of the gifts from the three wise men. So it has lots of ancient history. It's really good for asthma and deep breathing. It actually triggers the parasympathetic system, and it's also really good at enhancing the meditative state. And then peppermint, but you have to be very careful with peppermint because it has been around forever. It's the Romans brought it over to England, and the ancient Egyptians cultivated it, and it's actually been used in the 13th century Icelandic pharmacopedia. Has actually been mentioned there for, and it's really good for bronchitis, sinusitis, and nausea. For the diffuser recipe, 60 mils of water and put 3 of each. So, or you could put 2, 2, 3, really. That's really probably what you need to do for, but those are the 3. Really good, smells really good if you like it. Some people don't like the smell. Of course, for all of these recipes, it's going to be dependent on what you like. Because some people hate lavender. I did not like lavender until I smelled real lavender. Because a lot of the synthetic stuff out there, it smells completely different than real lavender. So you might want to try it again if you decide you don't like it. Because it used to give me a headache. So, or the synthetic did. But the real is awesome. Great medicinal purposes for it. So I hope y'all enjoyed it, and we will do more of these in the future. All right, y'all.